Welcome friends, today we will be learning about adjustment inventory for school students developed by AKP Sinha and RP Singh. So let's start. The adjustment inventory for school students is a self-report measure developed by AKP Sinha and RP Singh in 1993. It is a self-report inventory and it seeks to segregate well-adjusted secondary school students in the age range of 14 to 18 years from poorly adjusted students in the three areas of adjustment, that is emotional, social, and educational domains. Let's understand all these areas of adjustment. First, social adjustment. This would relate to establishing good relations with family, neighbors, playmates, class fellows, teachers, and members of the society. This would lead to adjustment in any social situation. For example, a child may be a sister, a daughter, a friend, a student, and if she is able to justify and have good adjustment in all these roles, that would be social adjustment. Next is emotional adjustment, which is also called the personal adjustment. It is basically referring to be able to manage one's emotions. Parents and teachers are more responsible for emotional adjustment of the child. And the last one is educational adjustment. This would signify that the child is goal-oriented, is taking care of his role as a student, is dutiful towards his educational goals, and does not while away time and takes his studies seriously. Now let's understand how this test was developed. First, a list of 100 questions indicating significant problems of school students in the three areas, that is emotional, social, and educational adjustment, they were prepared. The questions were to be answered in either yes or no. These questions were then presented to 25 judges, all of whom were psychologists engaged in teaching, counseling, or vocational guidance work. Unanimously, they retained 88 items. And then these 88 questions were administered to a sample of 100 school students to remove any language difficulties if there were any. Out of these 88, 14 items were dropped as they didn't discriminate between well-adjusted and not so well-adjusted students. Remaining 74 items were then finally administered on 370 secondary school students of Patna. The final inventory consisted of 60 items, 20 items in each area of adjustment, and then the test was standardized on 1950 boys and girls belonging to 40 schools in Bihar in the classes 9th, 10th and 11th. So here, have a look at the final inventory. So the final inventory had 60 items, 20 items in each area of adjustment. The split half reliability was 0.95, which is very high, and the test retest reliability is 0.93, which is also very good. That's the remaining inventory. So administration of the test will start with rapport formation. You will make your subject sit comfortably wherever you are conducting the test. Then you would strike a friendly conversation with your subject, ask him about his life, about his schooling, his friends, family, etc., his interests in general, so that he is calm and composed and he is comfortable. When your subject feels at ease, then you ask him whether he is ready to take the test, whether you can begin with it or not. And if he says yes, if he answers in affirmative, then you read out the instructions of the test to your subject. Give the following instructions then to your subject. On the next pages, there are some questions covering your school problems which have two responses, yes or no. Read every question carefully and decide whether you want to answer it with yes or no. If your answer is yes, then put a cross in the cell next to yes. And if your answer is no, then put a cross in the cell next to no. Remember, your answers will not be told to anyone. So please give your correct answers without any hesitation. You may take your own time, but try to finish it as soon as possible. Examiners should remember that the subject has to interpret the meaning of the sentences themselves. However, if there are some difficult words and they ask the meaning of those difficult words, that should be provided. So the administration sequence would be as follows. First, we will form a rapport with our subject. Then we will give the instructions for how the test is to be done. Then the subject does the test actually. And then while the subject is doing the test, you observe your subject and make a behavioral report in your mind first, and then later on you put it down on a piece of paper. After your subject has finished doing the test, you ask him how he felt about the test, what was the experience like, and you ask him to give you an introspection report. Then once you have the inventory with you, filled in inventory from your subject, you would score it. And after scoring, you will make interpretation of the scores. That's how the entire test has to go. Scoring. The inventory can be scored by hand. There are two answer options, yes and no. For any answer which is indicative of good adjustment, a score of 0 is given. While an answer which is indicative of maladjustment, a score of 1 is given. Finally, the score, subscore of each domain is totaled up and we get the score for each domain. Now, the score on all the three domains is totaled up. This becomes the general adjustment score. Let's understand the scoring with the help of an example. Here, in the manual, first and foremost, we need to refer to table number 8. Table number 8, which is giving us the responses which are indicative of lack of adjustment. Now, here I have an example of the answer sheet. So let's focus on item number 11, which has been marked in red. The response given by the subject is no. Now let me check it with table number 8. In front of 11, no is written, which means no is indicative of lack of adjustment. So we said lack of adjustment will be given a score of 1, so this needs to be given a score of 1. Similarly, let's have a look at another example. 18, here the subject has marked yes. Now let me check it from table number 8. 18, lack of adjustment is no, so no will be given 1 mark here, while yes will be given 0. Since yes is indicative of adjustment, so here for 18 we will give a score of 0. Likewise, we will score all the other items and also have a look here. The items in emotional domain are these 1, 4, 7, 10, 13. These are the ones. This you will total up and this will give you the score for emotional domain. Similarly, the items for social are 2, 5, 8, 11, 14, all these. You will total up the score for these and this will give you the score for social domain, adjustment in social domain. Similarly, educational, the items are mentioned here 3, 6, 9, 12, 15 and so on. You will total up the score of these items together and this will give you the educational adjustment score. Once you get the score for all these three domains, you will total that up also and that will give you overall adjustment score. Once the scoring is done, then we will compare the scores with the norms and we will convert the raw scores into percentile norms, which are available for both the individual domains, that is emotional, social and educational adjustment, and the overall adjustment also. Separate norms are available for both boys and girls. Now let's understand the interpretation. Interpretation is based on the norms that are available for both boys and girls separately. An interpretation is made on a 5-grade key, which ranges from excellent adjustment to very unsatisfactory adjustment. So by and large, the scores on each domain which is below 2 or 1, that would be indicative of excellent adjustment, while scores above 11 in each domain are indicative of very unsatisfactory adjustment. Overall, a score of 5 or below would be indicative of excellent adjustment, while a score of 31 and above would be indicative of very unsatisfactory adjustment. Similarly, the norms for girls are there. Slight difference in subdomains, a score above 11 is indicative of maladjustment. A score above 32 overall is indicative of maladjustment. Overall interpretation, in emotional domain, those who score greater than 11, they have unstable emotions, that indicates unstable emotions, while students with low scores tend to be emotionally stable. Similarly, in the social adjustment area, individuals who score more than 11 are submissive and revering, while those who have very low scores, it indicates they have aggressive behavior. In the educational domain, individuals who score more than 11 are poorly adjusted with their curricular and co-curricular programs, while people who have very low scores in this area are interested in the school programs. Overall, a score below 5 indicates very good adjustment in all three domains, while a score above 31 for boys and 32 for girls indicates very unsatisfactory adjustment in all the areas. What are the applications of this inventory? Well, this inventory is designed to aid in counseling in the three areas, that is educational, social and emotional adjustment. And the items that are there in the test, in the inventory, they are diagnostic also. That means they identify the areas in which the child or the subject needs counseling. That's all, friends, for today. Thank you for watching this. Keep learning, keep growing.